To conclude, I would just like to claim that what is needed here is something which was already deployed by Kant, the German idealist Immanuel Kant, as what he called the public use of reason, as opposed to the private use of reason. What Kant means by public use of reason is not simply public talk and so on. No, for Kant, precisely, state institutions like the church, law, legal system are private use of reason because they subordinate reason to some pre-established goal, organize religious life, the legal system, and so on. For Kant, public use of reason means use of reason subtracted from the entire field of social authority and hierarchy, where you can, as it were, freely think, deploying all the consequences, and so on and so on. Why is this so interesting? Because today, I claim, in Europe, we are witnessing a great concentrated attack on this public use of reason. It's not only that you, by you I mean here in the United Kingdom, with your reform of proposed by the Conservative government, reform of the university studies, tuitions, and so on, that you are practicing one of the most radical versions of it. The same process goes on all around Europe. What we are witnessing is precisely an attempt to change university as a space of freedom, illusory as it was. I know I took my Marxist lesson, but nonetheless, as the space of freedom into what? Into a socially useful factory of producing experts. What basically, to simplify it, society wants now, by society, of course, I don't mean all the people, but those in power, capital, and so on, is to turn universities into factories for producing experts. As a French future minister told me years ago already, I was in a debate in France, he told me, take those demonstrations years ago, you remember, in the suburb of Paris where people were, the youth was burning cars in the suburbs of Paris. He told me, here we need intellectuals, we need psychologists to tell us how to control the mob, we need urbanists to tell us how to restructure the suburbs so that crowds cannot gather, and so on and so on. This is what they want us to do. Is this intellectual life? No. I think this precisely is not what intellectuals should do and are needed doing today more than ever. A true intellectual doesn't resolve problems posed by others. The first step of intellectual work is precisely to reflect on the problem itself. What if the way we perceive a problem is already part of the problem? What if the way we spontaneously formulate a problem mystifies the problem? I think that this is the task of it. So now I will say something which maybe will come